Day Street Books and Harper Audio present Pickleball for All, Everything But the Kitchen Sink by Rachel Simon. Read by Allyson Ryan. A note before we begin. For resources, a glossary, and more, be sure to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider, or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/pages/pickleballforall. For Kurt, my partner in pickleball and life. There are countless people I've met and memories I've made and will continue to make thanks to pickleball. You can bet anywhere I travel, I have a paddle on hand in case I find a group looking for an extra player. Dave Gould, 4.0 level pickleball player. Introduction. In March 2020, Kurt, my then-boyfriend and now husband, and I were spending the early days of the pandemic in the same boat as millions of other people, quarantining with our family in the North Carolina suburbs, adjusting to Zoom meetings and work-from-home life, and entertaining ourselves with marathons of Tiger King. We were craving new ways to pass the time and keep ourselves distracted from the increasingly frightening news. But our options were limited. Walks? Too repetitive. Board games? Too tedious. Group hangouts? Too unsafe. In other words, we were really, really bored. And then, at the beginning of April, Kurt's parents gifted him a set of pickleball paddles and balls for his birthday. Neither of them had any experience with the sport, but they'd heard from friends it was fun, easy to learn, and simple to set up. Besides, they reasoned, if we didn't like it, the equipment was relatively cheap, even if we only played a few rounds before tossing the paddles in the back of a closet, they'd have been worth the buy. Kurt and I were intrigued, if skeptical. Neither of us was an athlete by any measure, and our own limited history with pickleball was relegated to middle school gym classes. Still, it did seem entertaining, and with our Netflix queue dwindling alarmingly fast, we knew we could benefit from a new activity. So, after work the next day, we marched out to the driveway, set up a makeshift court with chalk and tape, and Googled how to play pickleball. A few quick tutorials later, we had a vague sense of the game, a new definition of the word kitchen, and a desire to just get out there and try things out for ourselves. Were we any good that first time? Absolutely not. Between my badly aimed serves and Kurt's too fast returns, the two of us spent the greater portion of that inaugural pickleball game in a perpetual sprint around the court, more focused on gathering far-flung balls than actually scoring points. Even our poor car, parked over to the side, suffered a beating during the game thanks to our wayward hits. But man, did we have a blast. Despite our inexperience and lack of athletic ability, we found ourselves loving every aspect of the sport, from readying our serves to judging each shot's merit to eking out the occasional, long-lasting volley. The small size of the court made things simple to navigate, while the flatness of the paddles gave our swings a wonderfully lightweight, airy feel. There was no drag like in tennis, echo like in racquetball, or easy misses like in ping pong. Pickleball, it seemed, was the best of all worlds, and with so few supplies needed, we could play it wherever we wanted, whenever we wanted. Which, naturally, we did. Over the next several weeks, Kurt and I became pickleball enthusiasts, playing near-daily games after work together, often with his parents joining us for doubles. Off Amazon, we ordered a net and some extra paddles. From YouTube, we learned a few more rules and strategies, some of which we actually managed to put to use. By the end of the month, the four of us were so into the game that we even set up our own mini pickleball tournament, complete with team uniforms, that is, matching shorts and tees, and celebratory Pimm's Cup drinks. Kurt and I won, but his parents put up a fierce competition. It was a great way to spend our days, but outside the bubble of our home, the situation was continuing to worsen. Across the world, the number of positive COVID-19 cases had begun to skyrocket, and hospitals were filling up distressingly fast. Masks were bought, then worn to the grocery store. Groceries were bought, then washed over and over. Back in March, when Kurt and I had originally left our apartment in Brooklyn to head down to Asheville, we'd figured we'd be there for 1-2 weeks at most, waiting out the worst of things and heading back once the crisis had eased. Yet a month into our stay, the pandemic was raging on stronger than ever, and our optimism had started to fade into despair. With so many unknowns and new fears taking hold, all the things that had once captured our interest, TV, music, movies, games, began to feel silly and stale. Everything, that is, except pickleball. To our surprise, pickleball offered what none of those other pastimes could: a safe, accessible, and endlessly enjoyable way for people of all different ages, body types, and fitness levels to come together. With only one or two players on each side of the court, and no touching required, the game was practically tailor-made for social distancing. And since there was no formal training needed to learn the basics, anyone could participate and pick up the rules fairly quickly. Compared to other similar sports and activities, pickleball provided something fresh and inclusive, and the heightened action of each match made it far more interesting than another walk around the neighborhood or overcomplicated card game. The more we played, the more I wondered why everyone else wasn't doing the same thing. Pickleball, it seemed to me, was the ideal sport for the unusual circumstances we were in that spring. Surely, our family wasn't the only one who'd realized this, right? Turns out, we certainly were not. One Twitter search for pickleball later, and it became clear that many other people throughout the country had also taken up the game while in quarantine, creating their own setups on driveways or tennis courts and buying equipment online. Some, I learned, had even formed casual leagues with others in their COVID bubbles, wearing gloves while competing to minimize the spreading of germs. There were parents playing with kids, teens playing with millennials, seniors playing with neighbors and friends. Everywhere I looked, pickleball was taking over, one homemade court at a time. As a writer, I knew that I needed to share what I was seeing with more people. So I pitched a story to the New York Times about pickleball's seemingly sudden rise in popularity and how well it fit the current times. A few weeks and plenty of research later, it was in print for all to see. Is pickleball the perfect pandemic pastime? The answer, countless others and I knew, was yes. In the more than 2 years since that article was published, I've heard from hundreds of people about their own pickleball love stories, how they started playing, what got them hooked, and all the different ways the game helped them deal with the isolation and frustrations of the pandemic. I've talked to parents who credit pickleball for getting their kids out of the house and away from screens, and 80-year-olds who happily base their whole schedules around daily neighborhood games. I've heard from non-athletes like myself who've gotten in great shape thanks to the sport, and serious players who've started coaching others in addition to honing their own skills. I've spoken with a small-town mayor who gets to know his constituents through bouts on the court, and a man who came out of retirement to teach pickleball in prisons and jails across the country, so sure that the game would aid the inmates' physical and mental well-being. Speaking of which, when I told my therapist that I was writing this book, she revealed that she was a passionate player herself, who spent her weekends playing games with friends and taking lessons offered through her town swim club. Learning that, I knew I wanted to chat with her further about the game and its benefits to players' mental health in particular, so I set up a separate phone call with her following our appointment. On the call, Patricia, after amusingly commenting on how odd it felt to not be talking about my problems for once, told me how helpful she believes pickleball has been for players during the last few years. With the pandemic, we've all been so isolated, and people are looking for a sense of community, she explained, and pickleball is perfect for that. Additionally, she said, the game having such a low barrier to entry means that players can feel successful at the very start, a rare and valuable thing in a world filled with challenges. Also, she added, pickleball gets players out the house and active. We're not sitting around drinking wine. Well, later we are, she noted. Whether it's a therapist spending her Saturday mornings at the courts, a dad practicing drills with his daughter in the backyard, or a pro athlete traveling the country to compete in tournaments, it's undeniable how popular pickleball has become. From 2020 to 2022, the number of players in the United States grew 39.3% to a total of 4.8 million people, per the Sports and Fitness Industry Association's SFIA 2022 Top Line Participation Report. There are now hundreds more courts around the country than there were just a few short years ago, including in school gyms, retirement communities, and country clubs. In some neighborhoods, new apartment complexes are being built with pickleball, not tennis, as the main outdoor court activity. Pickleball tournaments are also becoming increasingly popular, with major competitions like the U.S. Open and national championships drawing thousands of players and fans, many of whom plan their yearly travel schedules around the often party-like events. In Atlantic City, New Jersey, a tournament set for September 2022 is expected to be the world's largest indoor competition ever, with 7,000 players predicted to attend from all over the world. Worldwide, the game is also growing at a quick pace. The International Federation of Pickleball, IFP, has seen a 360% increase in member countries just since 2019. And players everywhere participate in overseas tournaments and clinics. In countries like Mexico and Thailand, pickleball-centric travel companies offer vacation packages where tourists can split their time between sightseeing and playing. Currently, some of the sport's top advocates are even working hard to get pickleball qualified for the 2028 Olympic Games in Los Angeles. An ambition that not long ago would have seemed far-fetched, but now is looking more and more likely to come true by the day. And with celebrities from Kim Kardashian to Bill Gates helping the surge by sharing their love of the game on social media, it's no wonder that pickleball has been labeled the fastest-growing sport in America. Everyone wants to play. And with the game's unparalleled accessibility and ease, everyone can. Unlike many other sports where factors like age, gender, or ability often act as limitations to entry, pickleball provides a refreshingly equal playing field, with opportunities for fans of all types to get involved. Any person looking to join a game can simply walk onto an open play court at their local park or gym without prior notice and rotate into a match. Even total beginners are given the chance to participate, with more experienced players often voluntarily taking them under their wing to show them the ropes. And the more players get to know each other, the more opportunities there are for friendships to develop. Tracy Holmes, a player, ambassador, and coach from Avalon, New Jersey, with whom I connected through USA Pickleball, told me that when she first moved to her neighborhood several years ago, she knew no one and struggled with the loneliness. I moved to a new area as an older adult and had to really start over, she explained. But once she made a local friend who happened to play pickleball, she took up the sport herself and saw her social circle instantly widen as a result. Now she's a passionate player with multiple close friendships, all thanks to pickleball. There are women and men I talk to on a daily basis that I didn't know 5 years ago before I started playing, Holmes said, adding, I'm a 60-year-old woman. Who meets new friends at 60? But pickleball has enabled that. Gender norms, too, don't hamper pickleball's inclusive spirit, and neither does ability. Joe Sullivan, a paraplegic player and coach from Naples, Florida, said that in his experience, being in a wheelchair hasn't limited his chances to play alongside others and make new friends. It's a very welcoming community in terms of able-bodied people playing with wheelchair players, he told me over the phone. Everybody is like, I'll play with you. Let's play. To me, he continued, that's the magic of pickleball. And it's the same for a wheelchair player or any player. On the competition side of the game, things are just as inclusive. At an average tournament, wheelchair players like Sullivan compete alongside able-bodied persons. 10-year-olds face off against adults, and mixed doubles matches, aka those featuring both men and women, are as widely watched as any others. It's not
just. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.